It's my fault. It's all my fault.
What's your fault?
I let my brother be taken away by soldiers. Instead of me. To protect us. To protect me.
Amir. Look at me. I was in the army. I've been to war. Most of us were just average guys. Being faced with unimaginable things. Being asked to make choices no one should have to make. Your brother made a choice that night that was only his to make. It wasn't your choice. You didn't have that power. You never did.
I still hear the sounds of guns and the crying of children.
Last night at the screening, a lot of people were looking at one another after the film, and they were saying, I'm never complaining about anything again. They saw what these children went through just to survive, and I'm wondering, does working on a project like this put things in perspective for you?
Yeah, I mean, I think it's all relative in life. There's always people in a tougher situation and there's always people in a better situation. But certainly everybody can get really preoccupied and both self-centered and sort of isolated at the same time. And to see a story like this, I think it does really pull you out of that and makes you think about your own life in a different way, but also the struggles of so many people around the world.
Yeah, my mini bar was not restocked.
Yeah.
Today, and I don't want to talk about
it. You okay? You gonna be okay?
Yeah, no, it definitely puts things into perspective. But, you know, one thing that I really appreciate about this movie is that it's not a guilt trip. It's fiction, but it's based on things that really happened, and they were so difficult to live through. But, you know, the experience of working on the film and the laughter that we shared, you know, between takes or at night, you know, Gare is not a broken person. He's, you know, it's an inspirational story and an inspirational group of people.
And this film, I think, really has the power to change people's views on certain issues, especially immigration. And I'm wondering, what was the last film you can recall that changed your view and the way you thought about a certain subject?
That's a good question.
I think An Inconvenient Truth drove home the urgency of global warming and how dire the situation is for me.
Probably the Muppet movie, I guess. The Planet of the Muppets.
All that felt.
So much felt.
Just to speak in a perspective of Southern Sudanese, I think this movie, The Good Life, is a good vehicle for us to inform the world about what happened to us in the past and what still is happening now. So I think that's the reason this is a good movie. And not only that, there's more stories like this in that country, and not even only in that country, an entire continent of Africa that have not had a chance to be told. And this could be a good platform for all of those stories, you know.
And it definitely successfully weaves in two very different narratives, but, you know, they both come together and share a lot of the same themes. So I'm wondering, when you saw the finished film together and you saw how all the different characters' stories came together, even the characters you didn't necessarily interact with much on screen, what was your reaction?
I mean, I thought it was beautifully done, you know. The whole first part of the movie in Africa with the kids was incredible. I mean, you read it, I read it on the page and was moved by it. But to see both, you know, thinking about what the actual young people went through, but then also just seeing these young actors so beautifully portray these things that maybe they've only heard, you know, whispers of from their own parents, and for them to get to experience in a way what their parents went through, it's such a full circle thing.
And one thing that Philip weaved so beautifully throughout the whole movie is that combination of sorrow and humor. Mm-hmm. Even in that first part, there's this wonderful scene where they chase away some cheetahs from a gazelle, and they're cheering, and then they realize they don't know what to do with it.
Right.
So even at the sort of the depth of despair, there's this lightness, and then that carries through the whole movie.
What this film is getting a lot of praise for is it's not about refugees being civilized by Westerners. It's about what they can teach Americans. And I was wondering how you went about conveying that in the acting and writing
of
it.
It's interesting that I believe that any immigrant, any refugee teaches the person they're with. I really wanted to get at the fact that we're all connected in this world, mm-hmm. and that we're all the same. And that we all share this planet together. And so I felt that this was a really great vehicle with which to convey those ideas and the very best of people. You know, this film is about the very best and the very worst of humans. And they're right up against each other, right next to each other. And it plays out with these multiple narrative storylines and that all sort of winds into, mm-hmm. narrows into one big thing right at the end. And so I loved being able to write something as complex as that, but also entertaining and interesting.
Kuth always says it best when she says, when she first read the script, she thought Margaret would be from South Sudan because of how authentic it was. And it's the truth. Like, she got every detail, every small detail, she got it perfect. And, you know, combined with Philippe Faludot, his directing skills, what he wanted, these two fought so hard to get certain things into the film that you wouldn't even know, because they wanted that authenticity. Yeah. And it's our job, it's our obligation. We have to make sure this film, you know, is correct and we're telling the right story. So with all those details that they've had, it made my life and Kuth's life and everyone involved made it so much easier to bring these characters to life.
I think that what I wanted to take away from this is that movies last forever.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they live on forever. And so it's a great thing for Margaret to write the script in such a good way that this culture is going to have this to keep, you know, for their children and for generations to come.
I don't think they're going to make it if they're not together.
I will pray for you.
Yardi.
Yardi?
It is a special name for you. It means great white cow.
Well, it's better than a lot of things I've been called.
Break into somebody's house.
There is a reason you do not have a husband.
Okay, thank you so much.